In today's video, I'm going to show you Divi Nulled themes and the dangers that lay within them, starting right now. First off, what is a nulled theme? It's basically a paid theme modified so you can use it for free. Is that legal? Actually, it is, because Divi is licensed under the GNU General Public License version 2. In this license, you may modify your copies of the program in any portion of it, thus forming a work based on the program. So it is legal, but will you benefit from it? That's the real question, because there are a few very big cons on this concept, and I'll show you in just a minute. First, we're going to check out if those nulled themes are actually safe to use. I managed to get my hands on 4 Divi Nulled themes. I can't explain you how I actually got them because of YouTube terms of service, but it involves some really risky and shady practices on the web. Oh, whoops, this website is trying to install a Trojan horse? Nice. Yeah, sure, I give you all my personal data to win a free ski set to eventually get a free Divi theme? Nah, I don't think so. The first thing we do, of course, is check all these files with my virus scanner. Here we go. Nothing is found with my virus scanner, so that looks really good. But of course, you never trust only one source, so I'm going to choose my files over there. No security issues found. So basically, there are no viruses inside these zip files that could infect my computer right now. So to actually compare zip files with one another, I need a tool that can actually compare every single letter in these files, because I won't want to do it manually. The tool we're using for that called WinMerge. With this WinMerge file, it's open source, you can just press open. And here I can just add zip files to WinMerge and it will check it for us. Now that's really useful. Let's start out with the older version. Let's compare a nulled version and an original version right now. I press compare and it will compare every single file inside of it for us. Now here we go, we can see a different. Folders are different. Let me open this up. And here we can see that text files are identical, identical, identical. And there we have a different one. Let's open it up. And when I scroll all the way down, I can see the differences here on the left side. So scroll down, whoops, here is something added. So it looks like just a space, nothing here to see. All right, let's go even further. Here we go. Oh, wow. Create user. So what this script actually does is creating a user called Divi admin with this password, and it's gonna set the role to administrator. That means when I run this theme on my website, I get a new user called Divi admin on my website. And I think they chose Divi admin, so it wouldn't be suspicious that there's another user called Divi admin. But the problem is I have a new user in my website, which is a really, really big security issue. All right, let me check another one. And we press on compare. Wow, this one is actually completely legit. There is nothing here that has actually been changed. Wow, I'm impressed. Let's check another one. So that's the old version, version 9.3, but let's compare them to the original ones. Here we go, we have something that has been changed in the page builder. Texts are different. Let me see what's going on here. All right. Well, this code, it looks like someone is messing with the user logins. It's going to change the role of the user called Rotarshiminda, and it's going to change it to number 1, which number 1 is, of course, the admin. So this file I got for free is also adding someone to my users. How would you feel to give the keys of your house to someone you don't even know from completely, I don't know, someone in the street? So let us check another one. It's an old version, 4.9.0, but hey, let's see what's going on. Oh, this one is actually completely legit. And again, I have found a legit version. Nice. But it's a very old one. I mean, it is almost 2 years old. All right, let's compare the last one. And again, we have some differences. Ooh, in a footer.php, and also in the functions.php. Let me check it out in a footer first. This is actually pretty funny because I don't know exactly why they added this. Look at this. They remove the original footer and they place their own link inside of it of 10 pixels. And I can't show you because of YouTube's policy, but it's a no follow link. So what good is this link on other websites if you don't get any SEO link juice? I'm confused. Why would you add this to a null theme? It just doesn't make sense. Let me check the other file over there. The text files are different. Let me scroll down to the juicy part. Ooh, they've added some code in here. Let me see what is a new function called the Divi theme update. Right. User Divi. Password Divi theme update version 5. Email update at divitheme.com. What is this? If it does not exist, we're going to create a user with this credentials. And the new role of the user is an administrator. I don't want a user with an administrator role, but it goes even further. What this code actually does is the username Divi is going to be replaced and it's going to hide it. Oh wow. Users count users and it's going to -1. This is a sneaky code because what it actually does is creating a new user called Divi, but after that it's going to hide it. Very sneaky code inside my theme. Those sneaky theme modifiers. Would I be crazy enough to install this theme on my website? No. What's happening when you're adding a new user to your website? WordPress automatically sends an email to that user that they have access and that they can reset their password following the link it's set in the email. So this is exactly like giving your keys of your house to a complete stranger on the street, but also with a tag on it, which exactly says which address they can find your front door. That's not very safe at all. Let me sum up the pros and the cons for a Divi Nulled theme. Starting with the good news, the pros. Well, actually, it's free. And there is, of course, well, another pro is, well, I tried, but there are no other pros on this, sorry. Let me tell you about the cons. Obviously, you're giving away the keys of your castle. Second of all, you don't get any updates. If you try to update this old version of Divi, this is what it says. You will need a API key. Third of all, you don't get any support at all. They always come with solutions and they always make it really fast, really nice, custom CSS helping you out. It's amazing. They really go all the way with their support. The fourth reason is, of course, you don't get to make use of their extremely much layouts. They have 286 layout packs with all these websites ready for import at your service. Because when I click on one of these websites, I can just click on it, and in this pack are actually 8 pages which you can just import on the go in your new Divi website to get you started. But you can only do this if you have a license with Divi. And last of all, but I think a very important one that most people forget, if you get a Divi Nulled theme, you don't pay for the actual developers that are creating these awesome products for you and for me. It's like going to church every single week and not giving any money in the offering. You're allowed to do so, but if everyone will do it, the church will go out of business. If you have any questions or you just want to say, hey, thank you for the nice video, drop them down in the comments. Subscribe over there, and you might also want to check out this video about cleaning up a hacked website. I'll see you guys in the next video.